So welcome to Vandana's Art, and now we are going to learn acrylic pouring. Again, I'm requesting everybody to keep yourself on mute. iPad, who has come, Taranjiji, Vinita Balla, please keep yourself on mute. Now, see, many of you had this question that we have these solid paints. How to make pouring liquid with this? So I will show you little bit with this. Vinita Bhalla, please put yourself on mute. I have taken out from the tube. Okay, now I'm showing you the simple solution. If you have to pour pouring liquid, then this is the pouring liquid. This is the company I get here in Singapore. Bristow, and I don't know in India what are the brands available. Bristow, we have to use one part of paint and one part of pouring liquid. I'm showing you first with the help of Fevicol and soap solution. So Fevicol, I'm taking, this is 1 teaspoon of paint, solid paint. I'm taking 1 teaspoon of Fevicol. This is the preparation part, how to prepare for the pouring. See, Fevicol I have dropped here. Then I will mix soap solution, and it should have flowing consistency. Okay, like our Viresh iPad and Vinita Billa, please put yourself on mute. We are recording the session and we don't want any sound, please. So 1 teaspoon, 2nd teaspoon, we have mixed, and now we will mix it.
Vandana ji, we are not able to see the tabletop. If you can just lower the camera a little.
You don't have to see. You see my hand.
This white color, Vandana ji.
Please put yourself on mute. This is a humble request. So this is a soap solution and Fevicol. One part Fevicol, one part soap solution, one part green acrylic paint. Okay? So we have to mix it nicely, and then after some time we'll find a very smooth flowing paint. If your paint is very dry, then you may have to mix it for a long time. Otherwise it will give you the smooth solution. Like you can see all of them, they are very very smooth. Okay, this is the solution if you don't have pouring liquid at home. Okay, most of the times due to corona, many people are not able to go. So this is the solution. Now I'm going to focus on my table. And I will show you the actual procedure. So I'm doing a spotlight for everyone. Okay, so I have already made all these colors ready. The first one I'm going to show you how to make a flower by pouring. So to make a flower by pouring, we will take the white color. This is our white color. The ratio is same. Half white color liquid. Okay. White acrylic color. Half part I mix soap and Fevicol. If you don't want to do that, best is to use this. Now, what we will do, we will take this paint and we will mix it once again. And here, see. See, Deepa. Okay, I'm pouring it. We want to make a flower, so we have put white paint in this shape. Okay, now we will pour the colors one by one.
Just keep it here.
Can I request everybody to mute, please? Now, here I will take a glass. In the glass, one by one depends on how many colors you want to put. See here, I will start pouring. I don't want to waste the color, so I will just use a spoon and give it a flow. Now we will start with yellow color. Okay, and we will see automatically cells will form. So we have to just rotate it.
Mishti, come fast.
You can see here when we are rotating, automatically cells are forming. We'll just wait for 1 or 2 minutes. We can see here. We can also use the straw. Now in the center, I've got lots of white color. To do avoid that, I poured little white, black, and on the sides, So you can see the shape of flower has come. And now to give a proper shape, I will pour little bit yellow color in the center. Okay, and in between the yellow, one more little drop of red. Okay, so we can give the shape, we can blow, and our first piece is ready. Now this piece have got little bubbles. To solve the bubble problem, I'm not very comfortable with this torch, so I may take help. So you can see the shape, you can see the flower is ready now. Okay, so this is our first piece. Once again, I'm requesting, please keep yourself on mute. And then I'm keeping it down. Okay, so our first piece is ready. You all can see. You can do more colors in this. It's all purely your wish, how you want to do. So this, and remember, in pouring, after drying, shape will change because colors will settle according to their own thing. So I'm just keeping it down. Once you have done, then please don't change the position. Second one is a very, very simple thing, the basic pouring, which we all learn when we start doing. I'm keeping the glass on this because liquid will pour, liquid will fall. So first, this is the green color which we made just now. I don't believe in wasting too much color. So I use very less color. Normally you must have seen the videos in which lots of color is wasted. This is the just basic design. I have to rotate the table, so we will make some place for, so that so much color is there, it should not fall. Okay, so now we have to rotate this table. We can rotate this way also, I think, and my turntable is already very dirty, so you can shake it also and you can rotate it also. When you will keep on rotating, it will change the shape. And now I think it's time to add more color. So we can add some hues of yellow. We can add some little bit of, I have made three reds. One is orangish, one is dark, and one is maroon. So I'm trying to pour and trying to make it as colorful. Now let's see. If you don't have turntable, it's not a problem. You can shake it, or I will show you how you can do. See the straw, Now we can see in between the color is very less. So I'm going to pour little teal blue. This is almost same process what we do in resin. Only thing, when you are doing resin, always wear the mask, because resin fumes are very bad. So our second one is almost ready. We'll just rotate it here and there. Pouring is done very fast actually. We don't use any brush. We don't use anything. And if we want, we can take little of black color and we can give some spiral shape. Okay, so this is our second piece which is ready. I will put it for drying. You all can see it again. See, it's a small thing. You can make coasters. You can do lots of things with this art. And when you make coasters, you have to put resin on it. Now this place, I can see paint is little less. So I will advise you not to waste the paint. Use as less as possible. And in this, luckily no bubbles are there, so we don't have to do any other thing. So it's looking like little spider's web, and we will keep it down. इसको सीधा रखना पड़ेगा, वरना ये shape ही बदल जाएगी इसकी. और इसको इसको दूर भी रखना पड़ेगा. I use the clock. Always keep lots of rugs with you, because you have to keep on wiping your hands. I'm thankful to my two friends here who have come to help me, because resin is a thing which is difficult to do. For myself, I can do, but for doing on Zoom is a totally different thing. Okay, now see, this is, we want to show the effect of waterfall. So what I'm going to do, I will pour little white color. Yeah, please put yourself on mute.
Okay.
Now, white color is poured. Now we'll start with light blue. Then this is called cobalt blue. I'll shake the table and plate, and then automatically it will mix. So some sort of wave formation we want to show. Now we can do one more thing. We can spread it like this, and here we can give a wavy effect. Freehand you give, and then you turn the table. Okay, please put yourself on mute. Thank you. this is giving a wavy effect, like a sea wave. Right now, it's thunder and lightning in Singapore. Now, in this, lots of cells are formed. We can do one more thing to make it more wavy. We can use a hair dryer and we can move the wave. Okay, only this much. If you want, you can have a better vase. If you are doing on a bigger canvas, you can do that. I'm doing only this much. And then whatever paint is there, you don't have to pay for framing. You do it quickly on the site. Those who are in India, you don't have problem of framing. But we have very expensive framing here. So what we do, we just take it and we put it on the sides so that our canvas is ready to hang. We don't have to spend another $40-$50 for framing. Now in this, if you feel white color is less, then we can quickly add some more white color. So we can do, you can see beautiful cells are formed. And it's really giving a wavy impression. Okay, and to kill the, luckily in this there are no bubbles. These small bubbles will die. It's not a problem. If there are big bubbles, then you blow them. Or if you have a torch, then you use them. So this is our next piece ready. And I have to keep it somewhere. No. On the glass, plastic glass, on the top of glass, in the tub. We'll keep it in the tub. Pouring painting, once if it is done, then we cannot change the position. Just keep it down. Because it will pour. Okay? And last one, which... I think everybody has seen on all possible videos. I will show you. For today, I planned only 4. And next class, we will do more. Throw. Okay, so this is our next canvas. I'm taking this. In this half side, we are going to do black. So, this half side, I need a brush here. The problem in pouring sessions, you have to be really very, very fast. Otherwise, the liquid will get spoiled. With pouring liquid mixture, it won't get dry so fast. And usually, I have old Pepsi cool drink bottles in which I store it. Then it can remain there for 4-5 days. But then you have to make quick, really quick. Okay, so this is half side. Now other half side, I'm going to do white color. It's a very costly hobby. Now in this, I want to give a shape of leaf. So let me try if I get it or not. There's no guarantee. And last is yellow. Okay, we have done this much. Now we will take an old brush and we'll wait for some time. Liquid will start going from one end to other end. And here it has become too much of white, so I'll have to put some more black here. We can actually make it mix because it's already. Okay, now I'm going to move it little bit so that see in pouring paintings there is no guarantee that after drying you will get the same design, because when color takes its shape again, I'm doing the same thing. Okay, I will take the paint and I will put on all the sides so that we don't have to give for framing. Now in the center it's looking little different, so I just want to do I think red color is adding the beauty and little brightness. Nisha ji, please put yourself on mute. Okay, so with this our session is over.